Hello, this is your daily dose of news from On Manorama. I am your host, Susan Jo Philip, and these are the major news stories of the day. First is an update on the Sudan clash and India's efforts to bring its citizens back. Prime Minister Modi authorizes to prepare contingency evacuation plan to ensure the safety of over 3,000 Indian citizens currently located throughout the crisis-ridden country. Twitter has removed blue ticks from accounts. VIPs around the globe, including Shah Rukh Khan, Sachin Tendulkar, MS Dhoni, Virat Kohli and Rahul Gandhi, lose verified status. And from Kerala, the state forest minister has sought an inquiry report over the death of a bear trapped in a well at Thiruvananthapuram. At the same time, Menaka Gandhi demanded action against the forest officials. In the Godhra train burning case, the Supreme Court on Tuesday granted bail to 8 convicts. It denied parole to 4 others, noting their roles in the case. Dominic Raab has resigned as UK's Deputy Prime Minister. This is the third minister that Rishi Sunak's cabinet has lost in 6 months. Let's get into the details. With the Indians fighting in Sudan showing no signs of abating, Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi chaired a high-level meeting on Friday to review the situation concerning Indians in violence-hit nation. The Prime Minister assessed the developments in Sudan with a specific focus on safety of over 3,000 Indian citizens currently located throughout the country. According to an official statement, Modi, at a high-level meeting, instructed relevant officials to remain vigilant, closely monitor developments in Sudan, and evaluate safety of Indian nationals there. The Prime Minister directed preparation of contingency evacuation plans, accounting for the rapidly shifting security landscape and viability of various options. The Prime Minister expressed his condolences on the passing away of an Indian national who tragically fell victim to a stray bullet last week, the statement said. Meanwhile, Kerala Chief Minister Pinarayi Vijayan has requested the Prime Minister to ensure the safe repatriation of Indian nationals, including those from Kerala in Sudan. Twitter has finally removed the blue ticks from the verified profiles of many of the VIPs around the globe. Indian actors Shah Rukh Khan, Deepika Padukone, cricketers Sachin Tendulkar, MS Dhoni, Virat Kohli, Congress leader Rahul Gandhi and many others have lost blue ticks from their profiles. After several false starts, Twitter began making good on its promise on Thursday to remove the blue ticks from accounts that don't pay a monthly fee to keep them. Twitter had about 3 lakh verified users under the original blue check system. High-profile users also lost their blue checks on Thursday, included Beyoncé, Pope Francis, Oprah Winfrey, and former President Donald Trump. From now on, only individuals and organizations that pay for the premium Twitter Blue subscription will get the verified credential on their profiles. The Twitter Blue subscription is available for a monthly fee of Rs. 650 on the web and Rs. 900 on mobile devices. Kerala Forest Minister A.K. Shashindran has sought an inquiry report from his department over the death of a bear trapped in a well at Vellanadu. The officials have been asked to file the report within 2 days. Amid this, animal rights activist and BJP MP Menaka Gandhi has demanded action against the forest officials who ordered to fire tranquilizer shots at the bear. It is learned that a major goof-up by a team comprising the forest, police and the veterinarian to rescue the bear led to its death. Kerala has the worst forest department in India. Strict action should be taken against the officials who ordered to tranquilize the bear, said Menaka Gandhi. As the Rescue Act has come under attack, some wildlife activists are all set to approach the High Court. The Supreme Court granted bail to 8 life convicts in 2002 Godhra train burning case in Gujarat on Friday. However, it declined bail to 4 others, noting their roles in the case. 59 people were killed when a coach of the train was burned at Gujarat's Godhra in February 2002, triggering riots in the state. Solicitor General Tushar Mehta, representing the Gujarat government, submitted before a bench headed by Chief Justice of India D.Y. Chandrachud and comprising Justices P.S. Narasimha that he has some issues with the bail application of four accused because of their roles in the train burning case. The accused have undergone imprisonment for nearly 17 years. Opposing bail for four accused, Mehta said, from one of them, an iron pipe was recovered and from another accused, a weapon was recovered, which is a sickle mounted on a stick. Mehta continued that another accused purchased, stored and carried petrol, which was used for burning the coach, and the last accused attacked the passengers and looted them. British Deputy Prime Minister Dominic Raab resigned from the government on Friday following an independent investigation into complaints that he bullied colleagues, the latest scandal to force out one of the Prime Minister Rishi Sunak's top ministers. The loss of the third senior minister over their personal contact in the last 6 months will damage Sunak's effort to revive the governing Conservative Party's fortunes and is a major embarrassment, as he had entered Downing Street in October promising a government of integrity. Raab resigned in a letter to the Prime Minister before the report was made public. His departure is set back to Sunak just 2 weeks ahead of English local council elections, where his Conservatives are predicted to fare badly. And that brings us to the end of this episode. Thanks for listening to Daily News Dose, hosted by me, Susan Jo Philip. Daily News Dose podcast is produced by Vishnu Muralidharan with technical production by Idea Brew Studios. Follow on Manorama.com for detailed updates on the latest news, and be sure to come back tomorrow.